Baseball may not be the most popular sport in the world, but in America, it is considered as the national pastime. It's played by kids and adults alike, and the love for the game is passed down through generations. Its championship games known as the World Series played by the winners of American League and the National League is a must-watch event that brings together friends and family over barbecue and beer. One of the most exciting things that can ever happen in a baseball game is when the batter hits a home run. It allows the player to circle the bases and safely reach home to gain 4 points for his team, or if there are other runners besides him. A home run also thrills fans watching the game in the stadium, as there is a possibility that the game ball may come their way. If they manage to catch the ball, then they keep it as a souvenir. Depending on the circumstance and the batter who made the home run, the game ball can fetch a lot of money in an auction. For example, Barry Bonds' record-setting 756 home run ball sold for $752,467 in an online auction. The buyer was fashion designer Mark Ecko. Incidentally, Bonds also set the record for most home runs in a season with 73. He achieved it while playing for the San Francisco Giants in 2001. The longest home run in baseball history, however, was set by the Denver Zephyrs' Joey Meyer, who did it in 1987 inside the Mile High Stadium in Denver. The ball traveled a total of 582 feet. Baseball legend Mickey Mantle's record stands at 565 feet. Baseball has made superstars out of batters who can hit the ball harder, longer, and more often. But it is equally a feat for the pitcher to prevent anyone from the opposing team to hit the ball and strike them out. It can even happen that for an entire game, usually composed of 9 innings, not one hit is made by any batter. Officially, it's called a no-hitter and is really difficult to achieve. In fact, in the entire history of the major leagues, the most number of no-hitters stands at 7, a record held by Nolan Ryan. Batters rely mostly on their hitting power and accuracy to send the ball as far away as possible. Pitchers, on the other hand, use different pitching motions, grips, and wrist spins to cause the ball to go really fast, drop, rise, curve, or change speeds. Speaking of baseball, the actual ball, that is, why does it have its distinctive threads? Before we give the answer, please do like this video and subscribe to our channel. It will inspire us further to create more fun and interesting videos just for you. As you may have noticed, baseball balls come in white with raised cotton stitching. The threads, which keep the cowhide covering of the ball intact, are not just for ornament or branding. There is actually physics behind them. When the ball is thrown, the threads agitate the thin layer of air very near the ball's surface. This disturbed air then rotates as the ball spins. If the ball is traveling really fast, the rotating turbulent air keeps airstream friction lesser than what it would be if it's directly hitting the surface of the ball. The result is a lower drag on the ball. It is for this reason that the stronger pitchers in the MLB are able to achieve 90 to 100 miles per hour ball speeds. Without those threads, the ball won't go as fast or travel much farther. So, not only is the stitching required to make sure the ball doesn't disintegrate, but it also aids pitchers to control the trajectory of the ball. It serves as an equalizer between batter and pitcher and makes the game more challenging and therefore more exciting for both players and spectators. So that's why there are threads on a baseball. If you have enjoyed this latest episode of Aha, So That's Why and found it very informative, please let us know in the comments section below. Don't forget to like this video and to subscribe to our channel as well. Thanks for watching.